McLeish knows his Hibs side will be competing in the UEFA Cup next season. Craig Levein's Hearts could join them, and victory in the final Edinburgh Derby of the season would be a massive boost to their chances. Tonight, exclusively live from the Bank of Scotland Scottish Premier League, it's Hibernian against Hearts. Well, there's now only one issue to be resolved in Scottish football's top division this season, and that's who joins Hibs in the UEFA Cup. It's between Kilmarnock and Hearts, and it'll go to the last day no matter what. But a win for Hearts tonight would put them in pole position. Charlie Nicholas, Hibs or Hearts?
I think we might get a score draw tonight, I really do believe. The pressure really is on Hearts because they want to get this UEFA spot above Kilmarnock, so it'll be an interesting night for them. But there'll be nothing given by Hibs. You know, Hibs have been a quality side. Only 3 wins out of the 12 since the winter break. Not good enough. That's kind of mid-table standard, but they've been very impressive. Hibs be a quality game tonight.
I hope so, Charlie. Well, there's already been a game this afternoon, and Celtic have lost their unbeaten home record. They went down 2-0 to Dundee, both goals coming from Fabian Caballero, and Dundee held on with 10 men for nearly an hour after Zurab Kisanishvili was sent off. Now, it means that Celtic are still 3 points short of the magic 100. Hibernian know they're finishing third, but Hearts can go fourth on goal difference with a win at Easter Road tonight. So let's get to kickoff and join Davy Provan. And first, Ian Crocker.
Thank you, Jim. Well, one of British football's games of the season saw Hibs thrash Hearts 6-2 here in October. Can they follow that? They'll give it a pretty good try. Trinidad and Tobago international Russell Latapy has been axed from the Hibs team for a breach of club discipline, which was failing to turn up for training. Latapy, though, is also on the front pages of the Sunday papers following an alleged driving incident on Friday night. Freddy Arpignon comes in for him. Ulrich Larsen and Paul Fenwick are still injured, so former Fulham striker Dirk Lehmann continues as an emergency centre-half. So without the imposing presence of Stephen Presley, suspended after his red card against Rangers last week, 19-year-old Andy Webster, a recent signing from Arbroath, comes into a three-man central defence. Robbie Nilsson is handed a right wing-back role ahead of Stephen Boyack, and Gary Wells is preferred to Andy Kirk up front.
Yeah, Alex McLeish going with his usual three at the back tonight, Ian, and in the absence of Paul Fenwick, who I think is a hamstring injury, Dirk Lehmann will play on the left side. Did well enough against Celtic here last Sunday, a game that I watched, and he certainly gives them a very good aerial presence when they're defending set pieces. Hearts, though, I think will try and get the ball into the feet of their front two, Adam and Wales, both of whom are the type of players who are prepared to go in behind into these areas, and hopefully will try and ask a few questions of that Hibernian back three. Midfield's going to be pretty crowded as usual, both sides matching up in midfield with 5 across. I've got to say, you know, I've watched Russell Latapy a fair bit recently. I don't think it would be a great loss tonight. I think at times he's packed the tools away towards the end of this season. Ian Murray half year out on the left, an absolute left-sided player. Matthias Jack will anchor. And I think both Arpignon and John O'Neill will provide the cutting edge in Latapy's absence. Hearts with the two youngsters, Robbie Nielsen and young Austin McCann in the wide areas. But a lot of experience in between them. Colin Cameron will try and get himself forward, support his front two. Tomaszek and Flogel, old and wise enough to know when to go forward and when to sit. Up front for Hibs, it's Mixu Paatelainen and Mark Libra. Now, I watched Libra score twice late in the game against Celtic last week. Terrific technique, and it's going to be an eye-opener tonight for young Andy Webster, who's still probably coming to terms with his step up from abroad. This will be a big test for him tonight.
Hibs haven't won at home for over 3 months. Hearts haven't won away for over 5 months. Something's got to give, and something usually does give on Derby Day in the Scottish capital. Nothing less than 100% will do from the players of Hibs and Hearts today. Emerging from the stand that is being rebuilt at the moment at Easter Road, in time for next season. On show today, arguably the two most consistent goalkeepers in the SPL this season. Nick Corgan has forced himself into the Irish squad with some outstanding performances for Hibs. And Antti Niemi has excelled for Hearts. Finland's number one is attracting attention from some English clubs. fond memories for his fellow countryman Mixu Paatelainen of this fixture. A hat-trick hero in that amazing 6-2 win over Hearts here in October. His Easter Road future far from sorted, though. He's out of contract at the end of the season, but I doubt if that will be on his mind today. And the man in charge of this Edinburgh derby is one of the leading referees in Scotland, Stuart Dougal. Inevitably, on a day like this, there is intense pride and passion. The city of Edinburgh is bursting with both. You have to be ready for this, you have to be prepared, and you have to give your all. Hibs are definitely heading into Europe next season. Hearts could yet join them. A victory here would take the Jambos above Kilmarnock on goal difference and into that all-important fourth place. They would then be in pole position going into the final fixtures, which see Hearts at home for Dundee and Kilmarnock at home to Celtic. But wouldn't Hibs love to go some way towards scuppering their rivals' European ambitions? An early free kick didn't take long for the first foul, or the first yellow card for Frank Sozi.
Yeah, Stuart Dougal not messing about there, giving an immediate message to either set of players that he's not going to stand for that kind of tackle. And to be fair, I think Wales sees it coming. His leg isn't planted, he manages to get it off the ground just at the last moment there. But he's taking a sore one nevertheless. And Hibs have conceded a free kick in a pretty dangerous area here, because it's certainly within striking distance of Nick Colgan's goal.
Well, a year ago today, Gary Wells broke a leg and dislocated an ankle against Rangers. Sozi, one of the quickest bookings ever after just 10 seconds. So the big Frenchman will have to be careful for the remaining 89 minutes and 50 seconds. Scott Severin may fancy this. Hibs with everyone back behind the ball. It is Severin, it cannons off the wall, and Ian Murray will turn it behind for a corner, but a bright start from Hearts.
Yes, a decent strike. Walter, his job will held firm here, and you'll see that John O'Neill is a player charging on the right-hand side, but the wall did a decent job there.
Gary Wells has come back on to take up position for this corner, which will be taken by the left foot of McCann. And there's a bit of argy-bargy between Paatelainen and Tomacek. It's not taking long for this Edinburgh derby to get going. McCann delivers. It was away by Sozi. McCann wants a second chance, having been threatened initially. Nielsen gives it back to him. John O'Neill calming things down. Cameron drops it onto McCann. Hibs can't get out of their own half at the moment. Robbie Nielsen. Surely a flag against Stefan Adam.
Yeah, Stefan Lovell. Stuart Lovell did well to step up in the right back position here, and he sees this pass coming, and he just stepped up at the last moment. See him just on the edge of the box there. Manages to get himself up. Hearts have made a good busy start to the match, knocking the ball about freely.
It's 4 years since Hearts last won at Easter Road, and it's 24 years since they last went through a whole season without beating Hibs, but that could happen unless they get a favourable result today. Stefan Adam, who's missed so much of the season through injury. Dirk Lehmann being asked to perform a defensive role at the moment because of an injury to Paul Fenwick, hamstring problem. Ian Murray filling in at left wing back for another current casualty, the great Dane Ulrik Larsson. Scott Severin's free kick, asking a bit too much of Stefan Adam. The two Tynecastle tussles between Hibs and Hearts ended all square, but their previous meeting here didn't. 6-2 to Hibs, a memorable match, a pulsating performance. I'm sure the Hearts fans watching are thinking, how many times is he going to mention that 6-2 game? But we did see some fine football that night, and I seem to recall Hearts started rather brightly and took an early lead. Both these teams coming into this Edinburgh derby on the back of heavy defeats at the hands of the Old Firm. Hibs beaten 5-2 by Celtic here last weekend. Hearts hammered 4-1 by Rangers. O'Neill sets it up for Sozi. Ish. Sozi giving it back to O'Neill. Oh, it just skipped past Paatelainen. Adam. Matthias Jack, never one to mess around. He's won it back and won it back well. Lovell, oops, nobody over there, but John O'Neill will get to it. Sozi. Paatelainen's flip. Alpignon helping it on to Jack. Lehmann to Freddy Alpignon. It's a bit loose though, it'll be cut out by the Austrian international, Thomas Flogel. International captain, and here's Webster, the 19-year-old, filling in for the suspended Stephen Presley.
Yeah, I don't think that's the kind of ball that the Hearts front two will be looking for tonight, Ian. I don't think they'll win too much in the air, but they get into their feet, they might do a bit of damage here.
Libra steering that one on. And foul by Ian Murray on Robbie Nilsson. Craig Levine had an excellent record as a player in Edinburgh derbies. He only lost 4 out of 38. I think for his first win as a manager. Miami's kick. Away by O'Neill. Yellow card. It's probably worth noting as the game goes on, because I'm sure there'll be one or two interesting challenges in this game. Paatelainen, Hibs hat-trick hero here back in October. And these two next. Can throw. Here he is again. Offside against Gary Wells. Well, Alex McLeish has a rather good record in Edinburgh derbies. He's only lost 1 out of 8 as manager of Hibs.
Yeah, I think he'll want to get his cup final team on the pitch over the next couple of games as well, Ian. I'd be very surprised now if you see Russell Latterby featuring in the Scottish cup final.
His career may well be at an end.
Now, Paatelainen doing what he does best here, backing, and it's illegal use of the left arm that he's penalised for here, but he's always a handful, of big fella, and he gives Hibs the option of knocking it from back to front. And Sozi certainly has a range of passing to do that.
Hibs have only lost 2 of their last 22 games at Easter Road. Webster up towards Wales. Gary Smith though close to him. Mr. McCann loses out to Sozi. Arpignon steps in, finds his fellow countryman Sozi. Stefan Adam and Sozi both went for it. Gary Wells, oh, there was plenty on that, and it came off the post.
That's a terrific effort from Gary Wells. Look at the pace it comes off the turf. The goal mouth very heavily watered, I have to say. When we arrived at the ground tonight, they were soaking that goal mouth. and it zips off the turf there, and there's enough pace on it to beat Nick Colgan, who's very relieved to see that come back off his left-hand post.
Well, I mentioned earlier that a year ago today he broke his leg. It's been a nightmare season for him, but that would have been the definite high point, and that one skidded in rather than off the post. O'Neill cut out by Cameron, and Flogel will benefit. Austin McCann away to his left-hand side. Wilson by Van Airdrie. McCann's cross, not quite what was required.
It's not the worst cross you'll see, though, Ian. He's playing into a good area at the back post, and once again you see his willingness to get forward there. He's got a good left foot, and his final ball is more than decent. I think he'll turn out to be a pretty good investment for Hearts.
Paatelainen rising with Severin and then blocking Nielsen's clearance and then putting McKenna under pressure. O'Neill sliding it back to Lehman. Gary Smith. He's had an excellent season. Arpignon chasing, but it'll roll, it'll bounce through to Niemi.
I think young McKenna had it covered anyway. It's McKenna who's playing central there. Good to run forward though.
Flogel. Somebody flew in with that challenge. Jack finds Arpignon. He's still going, just. Arpignon trying to put Murray in. Nielsen couldn't quite stick with him, and it's a corner.
Yeah, well worked move there. Managed to get Ian Murray down the outside, but it's Kevin McKenna who defends the front post well here. His automatic reaction here is to get himself to the front post and make the block. Did a good job there.
He looks a player, the young Canadian. He's on loan at the moment, but they hope to talk about a permanent deal. The Neil's corner on by Libra, if I'm not on by him, has to come off the Hearts body. Maybe that of Severin.
Yeah, he's taking a slow one there from Scott Severin. Ball hung up to the front post there. Libra brave enough to go in. And that's the one that Scott Severin back in his feet. This game will be right up his street, Ian. Very strong, very aggressive. And I'm hoping that we can keep Mixu Paatelainen quiet when Hibs do throw it long throughout the game.
Well, he's not going to be around at this corner, which will be of some concern to Hearts. Hibs having to take advantage of his temporary absence. O'Neill delivers away by a dam. And Wales trying to skip past Sozi. Here's Libra. Lovell. Won by Jack to Paatelainen. Stuart Lovell. Scott Severin is not going to be able to continue, I don't think, for Hearts. As Lovell decides on a change of flanks, here's Arpignon. And they've indicated that Scott Severin won't be able to continue. Meantime, Hibs are putting the pressure on. Jack ready to deliver, Libra at the near post. And O'Neill could yet come in on it. And the Emmy eventually gets to grips with it.
Now once again, Hibs getting a good bit of work this time down the right-hand side, and Libra did well here to get across the front of Kevin McKenna at the front post. Doesn't really get anything on the header, but it falls into a tricky area there for Hearts to defend, and Emi eventually comes to take the catch. But they are going to miss Scott Severin. Hearts.
Neil's got a problem for Hibs as well, but Hearts have been forced into making an early change with Grant Murray coming on for the injured Scott Severin. And all fears were realised.
Yeah, terrific man marker, Grant Murray. And you can understand why he spends a good bit of the season frustrated him, because he's more often than not, he's not first choice, but a very capable defender nevertheless.
think John O'Neill will be okay to continue. Severin a little bit concussed, we understand. No wonder after taking that whack. So sadly he'll play no further part, Grant Murray on in his place. Hibs, despite having an excellent season, haven't won at home for over 3 months now. We'll be able to put that right in their last home game. Out in style here. They go to Rangers for their last league fixture next week and then face the other half of the Old Firm in the Scottish Cup final on the 26th of May. Nielsen's long throw. Oh, it went right through to Stefan Adam! And somehow it's blocked away. But what a chance for Adam.
Now they've just caught with the length of the throw from Robbie Nielsen. This is a terrific chance for Stefan Adam. I think if his first touch is better here, Ian is going to score. But it's not quite good enough, and Gary Smith manages to turn round and get the tackle in. And that has to go down as a decent chance there.
So as he gives it to Matthias Jack. Here is Smith, who made that timely tackle. Paatelainen's header will drop over the crossbar, guarded by his fellow Finn Niemi.
Yeah, I mean, I think he's probably trying to score here, Mixu Paatelainen. He's going to take a special header from there, but he's always liable to win you a knockdown as well from that area. And that's what Hearts are going to have to react to tonight, the second ball. And we're dead level so far. I think there are a few twists and turns tonight, and I think this may develop into a pretty decent game.
Aimlessly into the air. Cameron has flipped that on to Stefan Adam. He's onside. Gary Wales waiting for a cross. He's got it. And Gary Wales, what a brilliant save from Nick Corgan, which kind of sums up his season. But Hearts will see it as an opportunity squandered.
Well, it's Gary Smith who plays Stefan Adam onside. Gary Smith in the right back position. Terrific ball by Adam here. Wales couldn't have asked for a better ball across the face of goal. Corgan spreading himself here, and he really has to just hope that he gets in the road of that shot, and he does, but it has to go down as a terrific save by Nick Corgan.
Two quick chances though for Hearts, which they haven't taken. They did strike first here in that 6-2 defeat in October. Not that it mattered much at the end of the day. And apologies to Hearts fans for mentioning the 6-2 again. Tomaszek. Nielsen. Sturplane has got this covered. He's going to play it safe though with Adam lurking. Now, Robbie Nielsen's last long throw gave Hibs all sorts of problems. They deal with this one rather better. We'll turn that back to Niemi. Lehmann taken out by Tomaszek.
Yeah, pretty blatant here. Stefan Adam thought he was in here. But Lehmann just prevented from getting himself off the ground there. Did well against Celtic last Sunday. I was through that game, Ian. And defence set pieces so well for them, but if you're Stefan Adam playing down his side, you want to get on the ball as often as possible and go and ask a few questions of him.
Here's Arpignon. Jack. Smith. Up towards Paatelainen. Nicely on from him. Arpignon's cross. Murray is in there. Hearts living very dangerously. Libra was looking too.
Once again, it's a magnificent delivery from wide right from Freddy Arpignon. Libra can't quite get himself to the front post this time. What a good ball in though. Grant Murray did just enough at the front post, and eventually Hearts managed to scramble it clear. But I think Fish will be encouraged at the width he's getting and the quality of delivery.
O'Neill's corner. Jimmy Emmy in the end. Actually made his Hearts debut against Hibs in a 3-0 defeat. Cameron knocking that on, but it'll go through to Corgan. He's only missed one game all season. Smith. Too much on that, it'll shift behind, the ball quickly going from one end to the other and back again. Alex McLeish led Motherwell into second place 6 years ago. Some achievement this season though is what he's done at Hibs, a club transformed. They're in the cup final for the first time in 22 years, hoping to win it for the first time in 99 years. Celtic though might have something to say about all of that. Susie. Cameron. Murray. Nielsen, one of the crop of youngsters at Tynecastle. He's 20 years of age, making his Edinburgh Derby debut. Times against Hibs for Edry and lost all four games, so he'll be hoping his luck changes now he's in a Hearts shirt. Timoshev knocking that one into touch, a bit of a scrappy couple of minutes this. But it's been pretty decent overall so far, no goals though. We approach the midway point of the first half. It on, but McKenna holding firm. Matthias Jack sending it back, and McKenna is there again. Here's Nielsen. Now Gary Wales. Lehmann was quickly upon him though. Nielsen, very much a long throw expert, as we've seen already. Throw. Jambo's encouraged by Kilmarnock's heavy defeat at Rangers yesterday, which further damaged their goal difference, of course. Hearts have a much better goal difference, so were they to win today, they would go into fourth place by virtue of that. But Weaver had the advantage play.
Yeah, he did, and Stuart Dougal might have forgiven him it as well there, I think, Ian. He's definitely caught late here, and you can see why Stuart Dougal would choose to halt the play, but he was still up on his feet quick enough to try and play the ball forward. And this lad's technique really is first class.
Libra has scored in the last three games, by the way, so watch out for him. O'Neill. O'Neill and Arpignon and Adam all together, and a bit of a nasty one by the look of it for Stefan Adam. John O'Neill. His delivery hands. Scrambled away by McKenna. Paatelainen not giving it up. And he's got the corner as a result.
They're going to struggle a bit, I think, Hearts, now that Scott Servan's gone off. I think Mixu Paatelainen would have welcomed that change. Not going to see his chances at winning a few now.
And it comes, and Libra's header. Will drop kiss wide, the post was guarded.
There's only 12 yards out, Ian, but he gets an awful lot of room here as the ball comes in. He's under no real pressure at all there on the penalty spot. And with a bit more accurate direction, it might have been ahead there.
Mark Libra is only on loan at Hibs from Toulouse, and I believe they're asking around £1 million to make the deal permanent, which might be a bit beyond Hibs' resources. But I'm sure they will try and get the fee down a little bit. defender. Dealt with admirably by Gary Smith, as he's dealt with most things this season. Sozi. Libra, what a pass, but McKenna stopped Libra in his tracks. Kevin McKenna, like Libra, on loan from the German club Energie Cottbus. Stuart Lovell's throw to Arpignan, and it comes to the Australian. And he's lost out to Clover. Jack Paatelainen. Jack going for the return. Comes into Libra's path. This could be promising. It's Mark Libra! Oh, he's dragged it wide, having done everything so right.
Now look at the quality of the footwork in. Mentioned his technique earlier. Wonderful ability to ghost past defenders here. Digs it out from between his feet initially, skips away there from McKenna. Did everything right with the finish, which by his own standards was poor.
His first Edinburgh derby. He has actually 4 goals in his last 3 games. He was at Marseille with Frank Sozi, where his strike partners included the likes of Tony Cascarino, Alan Potsic and Rudy Voller. Offside against Wales. Hearts haven't won away in the Scottish Premier League since December, over 5 long months ago. They have the worst away record, in fact, of the top 6 teams. Just 3 wins on the road, but they haven't had to go very far on the road to come here today, of course. It's 0-0 in this Edinburgh derby. Craig Levine took over in December. Libra, bit of a juggling act. Libra certainly giving the Hibs fans a bit of a buzz when he gets the ball.
It's a treat to watch this fella. Bit of an economy player. At times you think you probably wouldn't have to wash his jersey after the game, but if you can get him on the ball in the right areas, he will go past defenders and get shots on target.
Smith. Paatelainen. Here's John O'Neill. Cameron is with him. Can't shake him off. Support arrives from Lehman. And back it goes to Sozi. As cool as ever. Lehman. Good run by Arpignan. And he skips away from Cameron. And Libra trying to turn and shoot. Lehman ready to deliver. It wasn't the best of crosses, although having said that, it still ended up with a kind of an attempt on goal from Mark Libra.
Yeah, once again the Hibs get down the outside, this time down the left. I think Colin Cameron might have been disappointed that he allowed Arpignan to get the cross in here on the byline. And once the ball comes in, Hearts are scrambling, Libra doesn't really get a hold of it.
Sub for the injured Scott Severin. Wales gives it to Tomaszek. Here's McCann. Flogel. Tracked by Gary Smith. McCann delivers. Away by Sozi though.
Yeah, I don't think any real surprise that Hibs are having the lion's share of the ball now. I mean, they appear to have settled now, looking the more dangerous side, getting down the outside, getting a decent quality into the box, and Hearts, who made a very good start to the match, really been forced onto the back foot now.
Sozi, trying to Redbird's spectacular clearance, which didn't quite come off. Tomaszek is putting himself about. Here's McCann. Gary Wells trying to get in front of Lehmann, but fouling him in the process. And Arpignan getting in each other's way. Another Frenchman arrives on the scene in a dam, and the free kick goes the way of Hearts. Flobel. McCann. Flobel. Cameron. Paatelainen read that. Murray. And Matthijs Jack popping up. Kevin McKenna. He's been given the free kick against him then, but he is making a name for himself.
Yeah, he might consider himself unlucky there. I think he's entitled to go and squeeze this out in the touchline. He matches Matthijs Jack's run all the way here. I think they're both using their hands. But it does give Hibs a chance to try and pick out Mixu Paatelainen again. Lehmann's gone forward as well, and he's no slouch in there.
O'Neill. Floats it in, Antiniemi says, I'll have that, thank you. Niemi, bit of a bargain buy really, at almost £500,000 from Rangers. But the bad news for Hart is that there seems to be a few clubs having a look at him. This coming Thursday night will be a night of nerves. It's the second leg of the First Division playoffs. We'll have live action from one and the goals from the other. It's from 7 o'clock Thursday on Sky Sports 1 with interactive coverage available on Sky Sports Extra. A nervy night for Bolton, West Brom, Preston and Birmingham. Webster is popping that one out of play. Arrivals. Adam. Matthijs Jack. Helped on by Arpignan to Libra. Camille trying to get in. Paatelainen might. Nielsen. Lehmann more than aware of the presence of Gary Wells. Nielsen gets it back from Adam. Matthijs Jack though will poke it through to O'Neill. Libra with a bit of a chase on, and Webster is there, but Libra forcing him to concede the throw. Here's Arpignan. Oops. Another delivery to forget from Freddy the Frenchman. Lehmann with a firm header. Knocked back by Murray. Lehmann having to challenge again. It spins away towards Gary Smith. Lovell sending it back to his goalkeeper, who then scuffs it into touch.
Took him at least two bobbles on the way back to Nick Colgan there. You mentioned Antiniemi earlier, Ian, but Nick Colgan as well. The two goalkeepers on show tonight have been sensational this season for either club.
Yes, one would say the best two in Scotland, although maybe Robert Douglas might think he's done rather well, although these two have probably been busier throughout the course of the season. O'Neill, Sozi playing in his 7th Edinburgh derby, and he's not been on the losing side yet.
He's got his hands full on the Webster. It's a bit of a learning curve for him this one tonight.
Just over 10 minutes of the first half to go. Nothing between these teams. 1976-77 was the last season Hearts went through a campaign without failing to beat their city rivals. Here's Lehman. Now Jack. Arpignan. Away by Nielsen. For him, from where he cut out the route to Arpignan. Sozi, oops, left himself with a bit to do. Not surprisingly, he does it. Comes out. Flogel. Curious with Stuart Dougal. Thought he should have had something going his way. Here's Flugel. It's going to come to Robbie Nielsen. Cameron, the nearest man to him. And Arpignan got the ball. It's a corner.
Yeah, it's a good tackle. He's prepared to go all the way back there with Colin Cameron, who's taken up good position here in the inside right channel. Chance to deliver from the byline. That's a well-timed challenge there with the Frenchman.
Austin McCann with the corner. Tomaszek there, Adam there. Jack struggling to get it away. Sozi will get it away eventually. We'll be taking Hibs into Europe next season. Third place assured for them. Will Hearts be seeing them at Edinburgh Airport on their European travels, I wonder, as well next season? Kevin Cameron, a veteran of these occasions, his 16th Edinburgh derby, 4 goals. And interestingly, all those 4 goals have come here at Easter Road. With Murray being told to budge back a bit. It's going to be a half throw. Nielsen might fancy another one of his long throws. Cameron. There's Arpignan. Cameron. Fine challenge from Smith again. And nobody to latch onto the rebound. But it's not away yet. Here's Freddie Arpignan. Oh, it has come through. The level and Murray! And away by Nielsen. And just can't finish it, Hibs. And now Gary Wells looks to break away, but Sozi will have that covered. Showboat time. Flurry of activity in the Hearts box.
Yeah, Ali McLeish knows his side should be ahead here, Ian. And I really don't think he can afford to pass up too many chances in a derby match and come out on top. And it's Libra who managed to get himself clearing inside left channel first of all. I'm lucky to see the effort come back off the post. But an even better chance here, arguably, for Ian Murray. Timed his run perfectly. Might have made a better job of it on his left side, but it has to be down as a good chance.
Hibs well ahead as far as attempts at goal are concerned, but Hearts have managed to get a couple on target. Oh, misjudged by Murray, and Libra's in. Paatelainen waiting for the cross. Webster stuck right with him though, corner.
That's good defending by the youngster. Once again, Hibs down the outside, good ball in. Paatelainen, I think, trying to step over there at the front post. I don't think he was going to score himself, but well squeezed out by Andy Webster.
It's John O'Neill's corner. Oh, really an own goal, that. And is it? No, it's a goal kick that's been given.
That's a good corner, a lot of movement on the ball, latterly there. So Paatelainen who gets the header eventually. Just can't keep it down. Hibs finishing the first half by far the stronger of the two sides.
He's not scored in his last 13 games, in fact, Mixu Paatelainen. Marpignon. Chipped by Flogel. Not much done about that one, really.
Yeah, he could be looking at a yellow here, Ian. Turn here by Freddy Arpignon. Taken well late there by Thomas Lugo.
Well, he's let him off. Thanks to the dismay of the Hibs fans, who saw their hero Frank Sozi booked after 10 seconds. Smith. Arpignon is picking up in some useful places for Hibs. Lovell won't get in. Webster slamming that with some venom into the Hibs fans, and you can see what they thought of that. Not overly impressed, I don't think. Webster heads that away. Lovell to Jack. Smith. Oh, McKenna misjudged it, but Paatelainen unable to profit. A couple of minutes to go in the first half. It's lively, as it usually is when these two teams meet, but no goals yet. Paatelainen picking that one off. Murray trying to get in, Paatelainen is there, and Nilsson comes to Hearts' rescue.
Well, not just once, but twice here. Young Nilsson did superbly. You watch his reaction here. He's in there, manages to get it away, and when it comes back in, he's got to stick his head in again. Did well, the youngster.
Hibs putting the pressure on, and Lehman clambered above all and sundry. There's a Hearts body injured in there as a result.
Well, he claimed so well, Dirk Lehman. A very potent man to have around in either penalty area.
Probably McKenna paid the price, though, of trying to halt Lehman.
Well, having lost Severin, they really need him back on his feet, Ian, because they've got Wanjo, Stephen Boyack and Andy Kirk on the bench, along with substitute keeper Roddy McKenzie, so not too many options for Craig Levine in defence. Another kid did really well here. first header. He's right back in from Paatelainen, and once again he's prepared to put his head in.
It'd be Nielsen bailing out Hearts just ahead of half time. Kevin McKenna. He will be okay, I think, but he took a right old whack. The Canadian international, who was linked with Celtic earlier in the season, also linked with Everton and West Ham. His best mate is Owen Hargreaves, the England under 21 international, who starred for Bayern Munich against Real Madrid in midweek. They grew up together in Calgary, Canada. And header, Libra, he's in. Mark Libra, Paatelainen waiting for the centre, but it's gone behind him.
That's terrific play, but they really needed a midfield runner there, Ian. Paatelainen makes up the ground, but they really need another second runner coming in behind them. Great pullback by Libra. And no takers at the back post.
The flag is up. Perhaps it'll be rather a relief, actually, because they gave possession away pretty cheaply there. McKenna is back on for Hearts. There will be 2 minutes of added on time in this first half. The Hibs fans trying to encourage their heroes to glory. There's quite a few empty seats at one stand where the Hibs fans are. Only three sides of the ground in use at the moment, though. The side that we're on being rebuilt. And another blatant block by Webster on Jack.
Once again, I think it's fortunate Hirini doesn't pick up a yellow for that one. Cynical, to say the least, there by the youngster. He's quickly learning the ropes at a higher level.
Sozi will fancy this. Easter Road holds its breath as Sozi goes for goal. And it drifts away from its intended target. We've seen them go in before, though.
Yeah, that's the thing, Ian. He's capable from that range, a bit like George Albers in that respect. Doesn't really get over this one. But you have to treat him with the utmost respect in that kind of situation. And that's why Hearts are three in the wall.
Well, it was in the second half when the Hibs turned on the star when the teams met here in October. And that 6-2 victory. It's half-time at Easter Road. No goals, but Gary Wales came very close to changing that for Hearts when his fine effort shaved a post. And talking of hitting the post, Mark Libra did the same for Hibs, and he's looked more than useful. The thoughts of Charlie Nicholas with Jim coming up at the break. It's Hibs 0, Hearts 0.
Now there's live Spanish football about to start over on Sky Sports 3. Can Real Madrid put the Champions League disappointment behind them when they meet Espanyol? OK, at Easter Road, it's our live match in the Bank of Scotland Scottish Premier League. It's the Edinburgh Derby. It's goalless, but as Ian Crocker says, lively, lively stuff, thoroughly entertaining. Just one booking in that first half after only 10 seconds. Frank Sozi of Hibs. Finny Jones was quicker. But old Frank getting quick tonight. Well, Hibs have had the better of a really good first half, but no goals as yet. And Charlie Nicholas, is that bound to change, do you think? Because Hibs have a real grip of this game at the moment, haven't they?
They do have. I actually thought that the first 15 minutes was a fairly promising 15 minutes for Hearts. I thought they started the most positive side. I did say before kick-off I was expecting a good match tonight. I think we've had a good 45. I think Hearts started brightly. I think they looked energetic, aggressive, which is a good side of Hearts. And I think Craig Levine says to them, here's an opportunity, guys, to go and win this match. We know it's a derby. We know that Hibs will give us nothing. Gary Wales up front, I tell you what, he's quick onto that, Jim. Little mistake comes his way, but he tries to punish him early. Nick Colgan, who David quite rightly points out, has been one of the goalkeepers of the season, along with Naomi. You know, he's completely beaten here. It's the speed of the ball and the bounce comes off the ground and it beats him, and he's fortunate that it hits his post. This is a great chance. Lovely play from Stefan Adame. He just dragged Gary Smith across. And I have to say, being an ex-striker, that the priority is to hit the target. If the keeper makes a save like Colgan does on this occasion, then fair enough. Look at Smith, he plays him on. Stefan Adame lets him come across, leaves the space for Wales, and that is a save. It's a great save rather than a miss. Wales has hit the target, Colgan's made the save. There's not a lot you can do about it, although it was a wonderful chance. Libra, I've liked him ever since we did the Hibs-Celtic match at Celtic Park. He came on and rescued, scored that night and got a 1-1 draw. And ever since, I've thought Big Alec will gradually introduce him to the game. He'll be a prominent player, and I think he'll be a big player on cup final day.
They'll do well to hold on to him, though, Charlie, won't they?
Because £1 million is a lot of money for Hibs, Jim. There's no doubt about that. But, you know, he's looked pacey tonight. I think Naomi would be disappointed if he would have lost the goal at the near post there. He does get a touch onto it, and it fortunately comes back off the post for Hearts. I know Hibs' midfield runner has made up the ground. Finally, they get Murray in with a chance. It's just, you know, a typical, should I say, defender's finish. But as you can see, he catches it well enough. But Naomi gets a little important touch onto the post. But good play ever since that 15 minutes. It's been all Hibs. It's been impressive stuff. More attacking, more positive thinking from Hibs. Paatelainen, you know, again, young Nielsen does ever so well in two occasions. Paatelainen has done ever so well in two occasions.
But the door is still open for Hearts.
Well, we've seen enough in the FA Cup final yesterday. Arsenal didn't take their chance, even paid the penalty. Will it be the same tonight for Hibs? But yeah, Hibs should be in front.
At the moment, though, Charlie, Alec McLeish will be disappointed that they're not in front.
He'll be disappointed they're not in front, Jim, but he'll be very, very pleased the way that they've performed since the opening 15 minutes.
OK, so the Edinburgh Derby tonight, this Sunday night, still deadlocked. A cracking good game, though, but it's a match still there to be won. The second half is coming up. Well, football continues over the summer on Sky Sports Extra with all 26 matches in Copa America. The tournament runs from July the 11th until July the 29th. And of course, it's exclusive to Sky digital subscribers on Sky Sports Extra. And if you live in Scotland, you know what that is. That is haar. Edinburgh, that's kind of Scottish fog. And it's coming in tonight.
No, it's not,
off the 1st of 4th. It's the Edinburgh Derby. It's goalless. The second half now lets you join Davey and Ian.
Thank you, Jim. Yes, in common with the rest of the country, it was a pleasant sunny day in Edinburgh, but it now feels like the middle of winter here. There's a chill in the air, as well as the heart. Hearts will start the second half if they manage to beat their Edinburgh rivals for the first time this season. They will jump above Kilmarnock and into fourth place on goal difference. And then they would be favourites to clinch that European spot. They're home to Dundee in their final game of the season next week, with Kilmarnock home to the champion Celtic. But rest assured, Hibs aren't planning to make it too easy for them. They would quite like to be the only Edinburgh side, I'm sure, in Europe next season. Don't really want to see their fierce rivals there too. McCann and Flogel not quite on the same wavelength. No further changes for either team, but of course Hearts lost Scott Severin early on with a touch of concussion. Carl Murray took his place. Thomas Shepp. Of all that, we'll see a foul by Tomaszek on Lieber.
Yeah, once again, Lieber's the victim, but I think Hearts have to show more aggression in the midfield game, because apart from the first 10 minutes in the game, Hibs are winning most of the loose in the middle of the field and introducing their front players with far more regularity.
John O'Neill chasing that, but Andy Webster is there. Teenager. Signed from Arbroath for around £75,000. And given his Derby debut today in the absence of Stephen Presley, who's suspended this week and next week, in fact, after his red card against Rangers. Stuart Lovell going for a long one. Well, he looked like he was going for a long one, but then went for a short one. Paatelainen. It comes to Matthias Jack. Oh, what a fine strike, and it was deflected onto the bar and over.
I think Colin Cameron a bit relieved to see this finish over the top, Ian, because he was very slack as the ball broke. The touch let him down, and Jack needed no encouragement at all to get the shot away. Plenty on it, and he's a fraction out. Terrific effort there by Matthias Jack, playing in his usual holding role tonight, but still prepared to get himself forward into those kind of areas.
O'Neill floats the corner in. It comes to Frank Sozi. I think that's going to go for a throw-in, actually. Skewed a little bit by Sozi. Such a strong influence on this Hibs team. In fact, how about this for a stat? He's missed 5 league games this season, Frank Sozi, and Hibs have only picked up 1 point in those 5 games, which shows you just how important he is to them. Certainly become a chilly, breezy, misty evening in Edinburgh. I should have bought my big jacket. Lehman. And we'll drift through to Antti Niemi though. The fact that it was goalless in the first half means that Hearts, would you believe, still haven't scored a goal in the first half since the turn of the year. First half of the 10 games they've played in their travels. Cameron. It's actually gone out. Tomaszek's header. Smith. Giving Libra a little hope. Actually falls into the path of Murray. Libra. Once again, some fancy footwork from Mark Libra. Kind of under the end, but he's got a corner.
Nielsen did well, though, because he recognised immediately that he was one-on-one here, Libra, liable to skin Grant Murray. Nielsen gets himself across, gives him a little bit of insurance there, and eventually Hearts get in the way.
That's another John O'Neill corner. Matthias Jack flicked it on. Smith away towards Lovell. How about that for a pass? Harpy Neon. Lovell with him. Lovell takes over, but free kick is going to go against Hibs in favour of Lovell. Alex McLeish hoping to preserve his excellent record in Edinburgh derbies. Second longest serving manager now in the Scottish Premier League behind Robbie Williamson. Who of course are challenging Hearts for the last remaining European place. The European place that came up for grabs because Craig Levein's Edinburgh rivals Hibs and Celtic reached the cup final, both of those teams already heading into Europe anyway. Libra. McKenna scooping that one into touch. Checking out a couple of his mates here at Easter Road, Paul Fenwick and Mike Franks, for the Canadian internationals, who are both injured at the moment. Cameron. Powered by Matthias Jack, who initially arrived at Easter Road as a centre-half, but has played a vital role in that midfield area this season. Gary Wales lost out to Lehman. Wales down hurt. Hibs not too bothered. Paatelainen tried to poke it through to Libra. And Mark Libra has made the most of this. And he's just held up by Webster. Lovell delivers. Niemi thought about coming and changed his mind. Paatelainen knocked it down. It ends up with a Finnish keeper anyway.
Yeah, he did change his mind, Dean. He was coming here early for this, coming all the way, then decided to take a step back onto his goal line. And ended up a comfortable catch. But previous to that, Libra once again proving a very difficult opponent for this Hearts back three.
Webster. Lovell having to steer that one out because Adam was waiting to receive. Andy Kirk looks like he might be about to come on. Peter Houston behind Craig Levein there, giving him a few instructions. A catch cross. And Cameron blocked by Murray. Here's Jack. Tomaszek stuck with him though.
Terrific tackle. I think even if Andy Kirk comes on, he Hearts are still going to have to get a far better quality of service into him. Here's the front two, Adam and Gary Wales, really haven't been well served at all, but for the first 5-10 minutes of this game.
Gary Wales, who's going to chase this, is going to be the man to come off. So he won't get a chance to make a lasting contribution there. Paatelainen flick that on. Arpignon's header. Tomaszek. Two big men doing battle there, Tomaszek and Jack. And now the substitution can be made. Farewell to Gary Wales and hello to Andy Kirk, who was just given a rest from the starting lineup today. He's been a regular in the team, of course. Kirk will be 22 at the end of the month. He scored the opening goal here in that 6-2 defeat in October. Already a full Northern Ireland international and some prospect. And certainly the Charlton manager, Adam Kirby, was watching Hearts at Kilmarnock the other week. I wonder if he was watching him, although a lot of the papers seem to think he was watching Andy Niemi. McKenna, hoisting one towards McCann, but Lovell was there. Nielsen, who's had a great game. 1-2 off Stuart Dougal for Tomaszek, who's then manhandled by Matthias Jack, and he's going to get a yellow card.
Yeah, he's been involved in everything in that midfield area, Matthias Jack. Looks as if he's really enjoyed this kind of tussle. But, Stuart Dougal, having let a lot of it go, has decided enough is enough. I've got to say, he's been on the wrong end of a few of these tonight. You might be feeling hard done by here.
Jack joins Frank Sozzi in the book. Nobody on a yellow from Hearts, which has miffed the home ground a little bit. Cameron's free kick. Tomaszek looking to get him round the back. Paatelainen has to send it behind. Some concern for Colgan and Co. Global's corner, away by Paatelainen. Cameron, that's into row J, I think it was. So Matthias Jack has to confirm he's on a yellow card. The big, fierce German, who's a little scary at times.
Yeah, I can have them closer there, Stuart Dougal, to call that one.
Paatelainen flicks it on. McCann just stopped that going through to Lovell, although Marpignon's trying to gate crash. Stuart Lovell, not quite sure which way to go. Get the chance to take another throw as Webster prods it out. Harpignon. Back it goes to Lovell. Can he get there? Nope. He's done well this season though, like so many of these Hibs players. Initially he was a bit of a target for the fans when things didn't quite go so right. But Alex McLeish always stuck by him, that's for sure.
You know, once again starting to shoot the action areas, but Alex McLeish will be looking for a goal here, Ian, because I'm reasonably happy with the way his side has played, but for the finishing. And he won his reward for some pretty good build-up play.
Hibs heading back into Europe for the first time since 1992. Hearts, of course, were in Europe this season. They knocked out by the Germans of Stuttgart, although only on away goals. After a thrilling second leg at Tynecastle, they'd like another taste of those sort of nights. Hibs have waited a while to return to the European scene. Although, of course, as all good Stamfordians would know, they were the first British team to play in Europe. And they reached the semi-finals of the European Cup in 1956. Gary Smith's free kick. Paatelainen knocked it on, but Grant Murray sends it back to Niemi. One up towards Adam. Here's Kirk, this time as a sub. He'll settle for the throw. 13 goals this season for Andy Kirk, second highest scorer behind Tom Cameron with 15. Here's the long throw expert, Robbie Nilsson. I reckon his throws are as good as Dave Channon is at Tranmere, in fact. And this time finding Cameron, and it cobbles off him. Ian Murray, one of Hibs' amazing young stars. And Adam managed to get the cross in. Nobody in there, mind you. Duncan Corbin. Corbin taking the direct route of some urgency towards Paatelainen, but McKenna dealt with it. Webster, Kirk chasing. He's got there, but Gary Smith also got there. Didn't get a game last season at Aberdeen. Gary Smith fell out of favour, but he's started every game in the league for Hibs this season. Nilsson is there again. 20-year-old certainly has impressed. Frank Sozi. Just over an hour played. Libra grappling and fouling Webster.
Yeah, Webster did well here. He just refused to give here. Made up his mind, he was going to stand his ground here. Libra backing in, and the youngster did well.
Logan knocked it off. Hunt seeking there first win at Easter Road for 4 years, since a 1-0 triumph here in August 1997, when the winning goal came from Neil McCann of Rangers. Paatelainen flicked it on, and O'Neill is in with Libra, and Matthias Jack waiting. Jack is there. Oh dear, he couldn't find the finish. What a let off for Hearts.
What a magnificent break. Lovely layoff by Paatelainen here. John O'Neill with a magnificent run, going beyond the strikers. Service doesn't get much better than that. And Matthias Jack will not get a better chance. Time does run to perfection. O'Neill's got time to look up. He has Libra. The back post ball is his preferred choice. And Jack unbelievably scuffs it away. Charlie was talking about hitting the target. You have to hit the target there.
Jack in the box, but no end product for Hibs. Away by Smith. Libra. Nielsen sending it back to Niemi. And vice versa. Nielsen pulled out that time, and now he's conceded a free kick, which will bring in a yellow card. And I think he knew exactly what he was doing there.
Yeah, no hesitation at all from Stuart Dillon. Matthias Jack, who has had a sound game in the middle there for Hibs tonight. Once again, prepared to go forward. Left elbows up from young Nielsen. And again, Hibs have a free kick, from which Frank Sozi might fancy his chances.
Nielsen, the first Hearts player to be booked. Niemi well aware that Sozi could try something special here. Will he go for the cross? It's Frank Sozi. Much in the end for Hibs, but they still have another chance to pose a problem or two. Lovell tees it up for Jack, who missed that great chance. Paatelainen is there. Pignon to Paatelainen. Goal kick.
It's maybe a better chance than Mixu Paatelainen realised here. It drops over his left shoulder. Robbie Nielsen ends up on the wrong side of him as the ball drops here. That's a difficult one to take, to be fair to Mixu Paatelainen. Just to be there as a half chance.
Paatelainen with 12 goals this season, but he hasn't scored in his last 13 games. O'Neill. Will take this throw, so expect a fair distance on it. Knocked back by Jack. Flogel beat Arpignon to it. Neymar having to knock it into touch. Nielsen. Should be Marshall behind, maybe. And again, maybe not. Together. I seem to think there might have been a premature decision to the lines with it. Free kick, the foul on Paatelainen, and took us all one.
Yeah, McKenna and Tomaszek in about Paatelainen here. The sandwich there, the big fin.
You know, he's staying down, he must be hurt a little bit. O'Neill. Arpignon. Lovell is hugging the touchline, coming inside now, but Arpignon's got a battle of his own to contend with. Oh, lovely turn by Andy Kirk, and Gary Smith's foul.
That's a delightful spin here by Andy Kirk. And again, I think Stuart Dougal did Gary Smith a favour, not producing the yellow there.
Good free kick. Not catching out Lehman, who came across. If we could have a ball, it would be handy. It is, of course, a building site, the side we're on, with the new stand going up, taking shape in time for next season. Here's Libra, and he's run that out. Oh, he took a bit of a whack then from Webster. The young boy can certainly look after himself.
Dead level in possession aim, but Hibs continue to look the more dangerous of the two sides. And Alec will once again rue the chance of Matthias Jack. I don't think he'll lose any sleep if he doesn't win this game, but you know, it's always nice to finish the season with a derby win. I think he'll be reasonably encouraged with what he's seen tonight, with the Scottish Cup final approaching.
Freddy Arpignon. Now John O'Neill in a bit of space too. Nobody outside of him. O'Neill. Cameron and Nielsen are both there. And a free kick given against O'Neill in the end. To steer that out as the mist descends even further across Easter Road. Grant Brebner is waiting to come on for the home side of a Manchester United starlet. Could well be Freddy Arpignon who makes way. Hearts are certainly thinking about bringing on Quanjo as well. The little Spaniard being given his orders. Also, there's one of his long ones, away by Arpignon, but not very far at all. Straight onto the chest of Cameron, but now Hibs can break clear, maybe. Libra. Cameron. Cameron with a foul in the end.
Yeah, he got there eventually. It was always going to bring him down here. Two or three attempts before he managed it, Colin Cameron.
In on Tomaszek, Sozi to Arpignon, he's bound to be replaced. He won't have far to go, Freddy Arpignon, because he's right by the fourth official. He's not looked at the board yet, mind you. Now he has. Arpignon replaced by Grant Brebner, who was on loan at Stockport earlier in the season. And he came through with some of Manchester United's big stars at Old Trafford as a kid.
Ronnie, sprint!
Brebner gets his first touch. Jack. Oh, it's presented to Andy Kirk. And Kirk has skipped away from Sozi. Still plenty to do, mind you. Hibs have lots of bodies back. Kirk looking for a dab. Away by Lehman and then by Jack. Smith overrun that, it's gone out. Here's McCann. Adam. And here's Colin Cameron. Stefan Adam! It's wide.
Well, Colin Cameron himself had a chance to pull the trigger and then decided to turn out on the edge of the box here. Still managed to set up a decent chance for Stefan Adam. He drags it well away to the target there, perfect angle to see it from.
Hibs only two places behind Hibs in the table, but there are 17 points between them. Hibs comfortably in third place for so much of the season. They were in second place, of course, overtaken towards the end by Rangers. But the Hibs will have a crack at the UEFA Cup next season. It remains to be seen whether Hearts will. They will know by next weekend, the final round of fixtures in the Scottish Premier League. Paatelainen amongst those waiting, of course, for the free kick. But it's going to be hoisted away by McCann. Oh, lovely touch from Stefan Adam. Didn't have much trouble bringing that under control. Cameron. Kirk. John O'Neill with him, but it's going to be a corner.
Terrific defending by John O'Neill. Has to come back 50 yards there. And he's actually got the challenge in. He's covered every blade as usual, John O'Neill, tonight.
Will give for a goal here. The corner will come from Austin McCann. Tomaszek in there. The ricochet favoured Hibs. So did that. When Craig Levein made his debut for Scotland back in 1990, he was playing alongside Alex McLeish in the centre of defence. It's a small world. And they were up against Claudio Caniggia that day. He, of course, now in Scotland at Dundee. Well, at Dundee for maybe another 24 hours or so. On his way to Rangers. Goals in the Edinburgh Derby. Two of the previous three encounters this season ended all square. Hearts fans won't need reminding how the other one finished, although Hibs fans will often remind them. Lovell going in with full force. O'Neill. Webster will let that one drift behind. This coming Thursday, it's going to be some night. The second leg of the First Division playoffs from Thursday at 7, with Bolton and West Brom tied at 2-2, Birmingham 1-up on Preston. Always great to watch, but torture for the teams involved. The one of the games live, all the goals from the other. Sky Sports 1 with interactive coverage on Sky Sports Extra. Tomaszek. Andy Kirk looking to latch onto it. Just nothing separating these Edinburgh rivals so far.
I've got to say the game's died a bit in neither side making a chance at the moment. Could do with a bit of cutting edge.
Sozi leaves it for Brebner. O'Neill. Gary Smith. Good touch from O'Neill on the wrong side of Libra though, and Grant Murray looking to release Kirk. Might just have done so as well. The 21-year-old Northern Ireland international leaves it for 20-year-old Scottish number 21 international Robbie Nilsson centre. McCann's kept it in. His cross, oh, nearly came for Cameron. Stays his way. Hearts will have to beat Dundee at Tynecastle next week and hope that Kilmarnock lose at home to the champions Celtic, although a reminder that Celtic themselves lost at home for the first time this season earlier today, beaten 2-0 by Dundee. And I think Ivano Benetti will probably think his team were due a result against the Old Firm. One at Rangers and one at Celtic. Somewhere in the closing stages, and maybe David Zitelli is the man to provide it. He often scores some great goals on Zitelli, of course, and he's warming up for Hibs. Nilsson's throw, twisted away by Lehmann. Free kick for Hibs.
There on the end of a long diagonal.
Lovell. And, oh, Libra had a go. Matthias Jack had another go. And still it won't go in.
I think it all comes from a poor choice from Kevin McKenna, who I think should have headed the back post ball behind and just got it to safety. Heads it into no man's land there. Eventually the ball broke nicely from Matthias Jack. Once again the finishing wasn't up to scratch. Libra first of all. Once again Jack snatched at it at the back post.
Dean attempts have gone for Hibs. Three times as many as Hearts, but it's still 0-0. McCann has a bit of a boot problem at the moment. Hibs, last game at home. And it would be fitting if they could give their fans a bit of a send-off. That's what Angus McLeish wanted to do. The victory over Hearts. An Old Firm double coming up for the Hibs. They end the league campaign at Ibrox next week, and then it's the Scottish Cup final live on Sky Sports. Hibs against Celtic. An all green and white affair, although both teams will be wearing their away kits for the big one at the end of the month at Hampden. Offside against Libra.
He's not happy about that. He's in a position where he shouldn't be cut off. He's looking across the line at the last defender. Let's see it here. Well, it's very, very tight. The system was well placed to call it. He really hasn't been in it in the second half, Mark Libra, after a terrific performance in the first 45.
Inside the last 10 minutes at Easter Road. Hibs 0, Hearts 0. Even if Hearts were to lose this, actually, they could still sneak into Europe with the victory over Dundee next week, as long as Kilmarnock lose to Celtic. Hearts with a better goal difference, remember. But Kilmarnock will have to give it all they've got against the champions, who might just have their minds on the cup final against Hibs. Clearance was interesting, but it actually reached Tomaszek. Nilsson to Murray. Hibs looking for their first win in five games. Hearts haven't exactly flourished lately either. It goes towards Stefan Adam, but Lehmann got to it. McKenna's header. Flogel helps it on, Stuart Lovell, has to turn it away. Vogel's throw, Haddam, and actually eluded him and skips behind for a goal kick, and it has beaten out, strangely.
Yeah, the game's tied, Ian. And I think Hibs in particular have lost their way because most of the poise and invention in the earlier period of the match was coming from Alex McLeish's side. Just urging David Zitella to get him a winner here in what remains of this game. You wouldn't bet against it.
Well, Juanjo and Zitelli, the two number 20s, are both waiting to come on. A Dam's flick to McCann. McCann's cross will clear the crossbar. It's come in number 20 for both teams. Juanjo, first of all, the boy from Barcelona, who made his new camp debut when Bobby Robson was in charge of the Catalan club, comes on for Stefan Adam. Number 20 is on for Hearts, and number 20 is coming on for Hibs. Mark Libra replaced by his close pal David Zitelli. Have the managers thrown on a match winner? Zitelli with 11 goals this season. Juanjo always capable of coming up with something, although all his 9 goals for Hearts have come at Tynecastle, not away from home. Here's Kirk. Juanjo waiting for the cross. Cameron in there too. That'll be a corner. So he's not looking entirely comfortable with it. So Juanjo just on. We'll take this corner for Hearts. Well, a back corner by Juanjo, in fact. And it was turned over by Vogel.
Once again, it's a decent chance here because it gets a yard on Matthijs Jack here as he comes in. Matthijs Jack underneath it. Vogel gets up with perfect timing but can't keep it down. Well, Craig Levine would bite your hand off for a winner at this late stage in the game.
It was 0-0 when these teams met on the opening day of the season at Tynecastle. It was 6-2 to Hibs when they met again, and 1-1 on Boxing Day back down the Gorgie Road. There's going to be another draw between the Edinburgh rivals. Smith's cross, Paatelainen's flip, Bremner could yet be in. He was thinking about an overhead job then. Zitelli definitely thinking about it. And Bremner with high feet on Grant Murray.
Yeah, he could have taken Grant Murray's head off there, but he didn't see the Hearts defender. Good knock on again by Paatelainen. Bremner in behind. Zitelli gets into a decent area there. Good decision again by Stuart Google. He really has strolled through this game tonight.
Inside the final 5 minutes. Is there going to be a twist in the tail? Grant Murray spinning away from O'Neill. Not yet come to Nilsson, although Ian Murray dispatches it into touch. I suspect this will mean a long throw. Don't need to be a genius to work that one out. Robbie Nilsson pretty good at those. Launch time for Nilsson. Away by Lehmann. Vogel. He couldn't find a way through the throng of players. And is there going to be a break on for O'Neill? Not really. Nilsson snapping away at him, but a foul.
Well, he's not afraid to put his foot through the ball, youngster. A decent game, Robbie Nilsson. Next season will probably be a bigger season for him, where he'll be hoping to establish himself under Craig Levein.
Lehmann. Now, this could be interesting. interesting. Flogel. Away by Lehman, though. Here's McCann. Webster. I think that might be a free kick. Webster floating it towards Flogel, but Hunt having to settle for the throw. Quanjo. Telly lunging in. McCann's throw. Quanjo just pushed out of the way by Gary Smith. Time to pick your man of the match, Davey.
I think it's the kind of game that appealed maybe to Robert Tomaszek tonight, who's been first class for Hearts. He's been the best Hearts player, I think. But I think over the piece, and I know that Mark Libra provided a lot of the class early on before he really bummed out. John O'Neill, for me, once again, has been the busiest Hibs player. He's been involved in just about everything they've built from midfield. And a real assurance about him now that he's in the Scotland frame, and he's my Bank of Scotland man of the match.
Yes, he had a contract at St Johnstone last season, made the move to Hibs, and he really has been such a key man in their success this season. Sitelli more than capable of really whipping this one in. Lovell standing over it as well. It is going to be the left foot of Zitelli, and it was not bad in fact, but it just behind.
That's flipped into the perfect area there. Robbie Nielsen manages to make sure his goal side of Lehman here at the back post.
Craig Levein wants one final push from his team, because a victory for Hearts, if they can snatch it, would put them in pole position to claim the last European place. They could still do it anyway. Ironically, they will need a favour from Celtic. 3 minutes of added on time. The last games in the race for a European place. Hearts at home to Dundee. Kilmarnock at home to Celtic. Could be in here looking for a winner, goes down, penalty given, right at the end, Grant Murray's challenge, a last minute penalty for Hibs, and it's going to be a card for Murray.
I think you see the experience of Sotelli here, gets himself across the front of Grant Murray, invites the challenge, well, was there contact? Was the challenge? Well, he certainly raised it well, the contact is minimal, but... You know, you see the experience of Sotelli, gets himself back across the front of Grant Murray. Knew that if there was any contact at all, he was liable to get himself a penalty. And Stuart Dougal immediately pointed to the spot.
Well, the pressure is on the man who scored a hat-trick here when Hibs thrashed Hearts 6-2. Back in October. Today, one goal might be enough for Mixu Paatelainen. Oh, Paatelainen puts it over! An astonishing end to the Edinburgh Derby. It stays at 0-0.
That just sums the game up. Alec McLeish in front of us cannot believe this. And I'm sure he can't believe the standard of finishing throughout the game, because Hibs have had so many chances, none better. And from 12 yards out, only the goalkeeper to beat. Again, you have to hit the target.
We'll see what happens with it. Paatelainen, it seems, will now go 14 games without scoring. The Hearts fans are having a good old laugh. Well, we're now in added on time. 3 minutes of added on time, but Alex McLeish knows that Hibs should have collected 3 points and put a real dent in their rivals' hopes of qualifying for Europe. It seems destined to end goalless at Easter Road. Squaring up then, and oh, it's a red card for Flogel's retaliation. He's sent off, and it's all happening right at the end in this derby, but Flogel is foolishly sent off.
He's not amused, Thomas Flogel. But he certainly got involved here out on the near side touchline. So Dougal satisfied that he saw enough to warrant the red card. Well, Lovell's in high, first of all. Well, again, it's minimal. Stuart Lovell in high here. That's probably what annoyed Flogel. Slightest trip off the ball. That's a costly one.
It's good. Lugal issuing a straight red card for that. Craig Levine's heart's down to 10 men, but it's a matter of seconds remaining, of course. Flogel will now miss the game against Dundee next week. Immediate suspension. Stuart Lovell got a yellow card as a result of that tangle with Flogel. The Austrian saw red. So we've had a missed penalty and a red card in the closing stages of the last Edinburgh derby of the 2000-2001 season. It's all over and a rather enthralling end, but no goals between Edinburgh's finest. There should have been one though, right at the end. Mixu Paatelainen squandering the chance to win it for the Hibs from the penalty spot. And there was still time for Stuart Dougal to show a red card right at the death to the Austrian Thomas Flogel. Hibs will be in Europe for sure for the first time since 1992. Hearts could yet join them. Craig Levine's side must beat Dundee next week and hope that Kilmarnock slip up against the champions Celtic. But on Derby Day in the Scottish capital, it finishes Hibernian 0, Hearts 0.
0-0, but drama right to the last. Now, still to come tonight, following us here on Sky Sports 1 at 8.30, it's Goals on Sunday with Rob Wotton and Ian Dowie. On Sky Sports 2 from 8, it's live US Tour golf from day 4 of the Baron Nelson Classic. There's live Spanish football on Sky Sports 3 now, Real Madrid against Espanyol. And on skysports.com TV tonight from 8 o'clock, all the latest football news in Football Latest. Well, it was quite an exciting Edinburgh derby, was it not? No goals, though, sadly. A missed penalty right at the death. Reaction coming up after this. Easter Road tonight, 0-0 in the Edinburgh Derby, but don't be fooled by that result because a lot went on in this game. It was action-packed, very eventful. With five bookings in this game, so say Lovell and Jack of Hibs, young Nielsen and Murray of Hearts, but right at the death, a red card for Thomas Flogel, the Austrian, which was a pretty ridiculous decision, we think. So Hibs are the better of the first half, but they just couldn't convert their superiority into goals. It was a bit more even in the second, but neither side, at the end of the day, got the better of the other. So 0-0, a point apiece. The Hearts goalkeeper, Antti Niemi, is with David Tanner.
Antti, first of all, from your point of view, was it a penalty?
The way I saw it at the moment, I don't think it was a penalty. I think Sitelli made most of it, and the referee went for it. But on the other hand, they didn't score, so it doesn't matter at the moment.
Do you feel so that you deserved a point tonight?
Yeah, I think in the first half, after that chance we had early on, Hibs was better in the first half, but the second half was more even, and I think overall the draw was a fair result today.
How difficult was it for you when Scott Severin went off injured?
Well, he was when you saw our defence line today, there was a lot of young players. I think the oldest one was 21, and there was a 19-year-old player involved. So Scott is one of the most experienced players in the club, and he's quite young, so it was a big blow. But on the other hand, Bert came in and did his job more than well.
Was it a boost for you when you saw that Russell Latipi's name wasn't on the Hibernian team sheet, Ante?
Yeah, of course, Russell has been magnificent against us in every derby game I played against him. He's been one of the best players on the pitch, and unfortunately he wasn't here today.
And what about, briefly, your chances of qualifying for the UEFA Cup now?
I think we still have a chance because Kilmarnock has to play against champions Celtic, so hopefully they can do us a favour there and get all the 3 points from Rugby Park, and we just have to concentrate and do the job ourselves and beat Dundee, which is going to be difficult, but we're still confident, definitely.
We shall see. Ante, thanks.
Cheers.
He's having a good season, isn't he? Ante, yeah. Niemi, the Hearts goalkeeper. Charlie, at the end of the day, you're disappointed we didn't get an outright winner tonight?
I was disappointed because there was many chances. I'm sure the story of the match we're just going to look at now. You know, the one thing that set out was the first 10, 15 minutes was basically Hearts. They went there with aggression, a little bit of pace and made some chances. But I think after that, it was all down to opportunities for Hibs. The home side were never going to give their great rivals any areas of the pitch to go and, you know, really work them. But, you know, young Gary Wales didn't get much service today. But the little scraps that he did get, I still thought it looked like. I'm a little surprised Andy Kirk was left on the bench tonight.
Yes, he's done well for them, hasn't he?
Yeah, I've been impressed by him. Maybe just wanted to give him a slight rest. Don't know why at this stage of the season. But I thought they were bright. Adam came in and he drags Gary Smith across here. Great chance for Gary Wales. But I have to say yet again, the key is hitting the target. He did that. I know he should score, but at the same time, it's such a fantastic save Nick Colgan makes here, because it's all about reaction, but he's also got to get it back out to safety. Wales does well, hits the target, should score of course, but credit to the goalkeeper, Jim.
And as we said, Charlie, Libra has proved to be an absolute eye-opener, but Hibs might have difficulty holding on to this guy.
Yeah, I would think so. I mean, they're talking Croc told us earlier, maybe the £1 million bracket. Now he's quality, he's technically gifted, he runs and takes on people. As you can see in this occasion, he's not much of a right foot. But his all-round game was good tonight, this 45.
That's a good foot, isn't it?
That's a good foot, but that's a good hand that Naimi gets on to push it onto the post. I think the keeper would have been disappointed if he would have lost the goal to his near post there. I mean, it was a decent strike, but good build-up play from Hibs. It was attractive stuff in the first half. Sure enough, it did peter out in the second half. It became more the old day. You know, kick and rush stuff and a lot of scrappy play in the second half.
Which was disappointing, wasn't it?
It was, because
it degenerated a bit.
Look at the stuff we're seeing here, the chances, the opportunities that came to Hibs. Hearts started brightly, as we pointed out. You know, double header from Paatelainen. I really think that this is probably as well. I mean, we'll hear from Alex McLeish, no doubt, but I think this is as well as they've played in quite a few months, because I think they really looked up for it. The tempo was good. All round, I thought they played well. No Russell Latipi tonight, didn't miss him.
Do you think he'll be back?
I don't expect him to be back now. I think Alex will go with what he's had or what he's got here. Matthias Jack again had another good game. Strong in midfield, great strike. I don't know why he got a corner for this, I have to say. A few strange decisions came from the referee today. But I think Hibs played very, very well. This is the areas that I like. People like John O'Neill, man in the match that David gave him. You know, another great opportunity. Runners, midfield runners that go beyond their strikers, that create problems for defenders. It's a lovely cross. Libra can't quite get there. Great chance for Matthias Jack. I have to say, all round, I thought Hibs football was excellent tonight. We've seen signs that Big Alex wasn't too happy with some of the finishing. It was not a penalty.
No.
Grant Murray does ever so well to get back, but he is on the wrong side. He's struggling. He's chasing. He can't get a touch in the ball.
But Charlie, is the telly, is he letting down a fellow professional
by
doing
that? No, he's not. Of course he's not. Listen, if he played for Hearts, Hearts players would be patting him in the back. It's the way that the game is. I have to say, if you're going to be cheeky and taking penalty kicks, we've seen some clever chaps do this in the past. Mixu is not that type of player. And that is a waste. That is an absolute waste. Because you look foolish when you try these things.
Exactly.
And this is a shocking decision from the manager. Sorry, the referee, Stuart. There is nothing involved in it. I don't know why he decides to give a straight red, because Mark Libra actually had a little kick out at a young lad, Webster, in the second half. He let that go. It should have been the same there. Bad decision, referee.
Well, Hibs, as we saw, they missed a late penalty, which would have won them the game had they scored. As Alec McLeish cooled down, I wonder. He's with David Tanner.
Alex, would it be fair to say that your side should have won that?
I think so. Boxing match sprung to mind. But we didn't finish them off. We had good chances and we missed really good chances. We snatched at them, obviously the penalty as well. Disappointed not to win it. Saying that, Nick Colgan has had two early saves that have kept us in it.
Were you pleased with the way at least the players lifted themselves after last week's disappointment with the cup final so close to?
I thought they were fantastic. I thought they played well last week as well, but we were much more vigilant in defence tonight in terms of the set pieces. We didn't look as if we would lose anything tonight, and I thought Nick Colgan, despite his slip last week, was fantastic.
Tell us about your thinking. What was the thinking behind dropping Russell Latipi tonight?
Well, Russell was in breach of discipline. He never turned up for training on Friday. Quite simply, we won't tolerate that. There's nobody too big for the club. If they think they're too big, then they won't be here.
Has he played his last game for the club?
Well, that's yet to be decided. I'm not in a position to tell you anything further.
Will that be the most difficult decision of your career, bearing in mind he's such a talisman here, isn't he?
Won't be a difficult decision for me at all, no. I've got to be fair to the rest of the players, and it'll be dealt with in the proper manner.
When it comes to leaving him out, how does that affect the team and how does it affect the dressing room?
Well, you know, we played against Celtic early in the season without Russell, who's away on holiday. There's a slip there. He's away on international duty. And, we brought Grant Bredner in and he gave a good account of himself in midfield, and we matched Celtic all the way.
Alex, thanks for your time.
OK, cheers.
Alan McLeish there telling it how it is. So at Easter Road, 0-0 tonight, the Edinburgh Derby goalless at the end. But when we come back, a check on Saturday's highlights and how Rangers gave Kilmarnock a real thumping at Ibrox. Hibs 0, Hearts 0. We've heard from McLeish. Let's now hear from Craig Levine. He's with David Tanner.
Craig, Alex McLeish wasn't a happy man. Do you understand that?
Well, he's at home and I suppose he'd be looking to win the game, and they probably had the most chances in the game. So probably, but I'm quite pleased with my team's performance.
How did you feel as though they reacted to the loss of Scott Severin? And bearing in mind, of course, he had already lost to suspension Stephen Presley.
Well, it's been difficult. I don't know. We had six under-21 players started the match today, which is quite unusual in the Premier League, and we had probably the youngest defence that's ever played for Hearts, I would think. And they coped admirably. I thought that they worked extremely hard and defended well.
Can you tell us how you now rate your chances of reaching the UEFA Cup after this weekend's games?
Well, it was in our hands before today's match, and obviously it's back in Kilmarnock's hands again. If they can get a result at home to Celtic, if they can win the game, then they'll be in Europe. We have to try and beat Dundee and hope that things go for us at Rugby Park.
Has it been easier for you because you've been chasing them?
I don't know. It's been difficult for us. We're changing things around here gradually, and while you're doing that, sometimes it's difficult to get consistency.
Now, unfortunately, you won't have Thomas Flogel next week. How did you see the red card?
Well, I didn't think it was malicious. I thought he's kicked the lad in the ankles. I didn't think there was an awful lot in it. I felt he was fouled, and sometimes when you react like that in front of the referee, there's always a chance that you'll see the red card.
Craig, thanks for your time.
Cheers, Dave.
So no goals tonight at Easter Road, but Charlie, plenty of goals at Ibrox yesterday.
Yeah.
On a day that Rangers came good.
They did. They've started to play a little bit better towards the end of the season, although they still take their gambles every now and then, and none more so than people at Lorenzo Amoruso at the back. You know, they get that little bit chancy. They take the risks. They don't get punished because the keeper gets them out of trouble. Plus, Craig Darboe, who mainly played up front in his own yesterday, you know, you've got to remember early in the campaign, Jim, Kilmarnock went to Ibrox and won 3-0. They outpassed them, they outplayed Rangers that day, and they more than deserved it. And going for this European spot is pretty important to Kilmarnock, and none more so than Bobby Williamson himself, who's got a very, very impressive record at Kilmarnock and getting him into Europe. But Ronald de Boer was back. It's a lovely corner kick. You know, you can see him, he just pulls back off to the six-yard line, gets a lovely glance. And can I say that finally a linesman has got one right? There's been a few this weekend that haven't got them right.
Yeah.
But he was in a good position and he got that one right. Good effort, that. Good save from Koss. I think if I was to pick a player, I think that's Guerrero, is it? It's a good effort, you know. I think I've obviously played, pick a player.
San Juan, actually, Charlie.
Is that who it was?
Good effort, as
yeah,
you say, though.
A player of the year, sorry, Jim, for Rangers, it would be Stephen Klaus. I think he's been the one bright hope for them, you know, whereas it's been a miserable season. But Lovin Cranch, who came in, you know, earlier in the campaign, hasn't played too often at all. Sets up Rod Wallace.
He came on as a sub.
Yeah, and, you know, I think all round that it's at this time of the season you're expecting to see one or two of the fringe players at Rangers who haven't had opportunities to make an impression, to say to Dick Advocaat, because I think people like Wallace will probably be on their way. People like Amoruso, I think, look likely to go now. It's a lovely header from him, but this could be second last game. Next weekend probably will be.
He seems to have soured David Murray, though. I don't think Murray's too chuffed with what Amoruso's been saying.
No, but I think finally now they've come round to the conclusion that it's time to let him go. He's got a year left in his contract, and I think for so long we've waited and expected that Amoruso would eventually leave.
But he's won back the Rangers' support, hasn't he?
Well, he has. They've always been pretty loyal to him in that respect. Craig Dargle finally got a consolation for them. I thought, you know, I mentioned Stephen Klaus, and I think he has been Rangers Player of the Year this season, but I think he probably could have done better there. But in saying that, you know, people like Amoruso, you know, has been dictating to Rangers rather than the other way about for a period of time now. And I think now, that's the side of Flo's game that I think we've touched on quite a lot this term since he's came, that he has to improve on. Mm. You know, and then they get the rewards because they can balance that little bit of aggression. Rod Wallace, I have to say, I don't think the goalkeeper Meldrum would be too happy that his angles were not particularly right. But, you know, Wallace gets another goal. He's always gave his all. It's been a surprise that he's persisted. Dick Advocaat's persisted with people like Rod Wallace. Tory Andrew Flo, he's gradually getting the goals. I think he's gradually understanding it. But again, the goalkeeper, you know, it's the same situation, even less of a power in that strike. And he must do better. He's been given a good run now, Colin Meldrum, under Bobby Williamson. Talk that a couple of English clubs have been looking at Meldrum, but I don't think he did that well on Saturday.
Well, Charlie, in today's other game, Celtic lost 2-0 at home to Dundee, both goals coming from Fabian Caballero. And all that means is that Celtic need to win their last game to reach 100 points. The real interest is in fourth place, where Kilmarnock need a point to be sure of the UEFA Cup spot. If they lose and Hearts win on the last day, Hearts go into Europe. And the final day's fixtures are Hearts against Dundee, Kilmarnock against Celtic, and Rangers against Hibernian. So the Houdini act has been done, Charlie, by Dundee United.
Yeah.
And how much of an achievement is that for them and Alex Smith? Because it's a very, very difficult season for United.
Yes, it has been, Jim. And the one thing we know in the past, they could not afford to go down. I mean, no disrespect to St Mirren, that they say that they can afford to go down, but I think they are equipped and expected in a way that this could happen to them more than Dundee United. It happened to United in the past. I mean, they did ever so well on Saturday to come back because they start pretty dreadfully. It's a wicked deflection, and it goes right over the goalkeeper. No chance, you know, he's stranded there. They suddenly get an opportunity to get back. Charlie Muller, who's done ever so well, and it's a clear penalty. Darren Dodge just never got control of Charlie Muller. He's turned him and twisted him twice, and it's just a trailing foot, brings him down. What another awful penalty. We've seen one tonight, we've seen one yesterday.
That was a howler.
That must have been a pressure time for Dundee United, Jim, because, you know, they knew the form lately of St Mirren has been so impressive. It's came too late for them. Hartley gets a yellow card, I think it is. But, you know, it's a lovely through ball. Silla gets onto it. And again, watch this wicked deflection, another own goal. And you just think, maybe Alex Smith, who's helped turn this round, Jim Loughlin, it comes off. He's starting to think to himself, well, I could do with a break now, missed penalty. Mm. And Hartley maybe just gave them that little bit of, you know, belief that they could get back in.
That was a bad challenge.
Well, I would have given him a straight red. You see Logo getting a straight red for absolutely nothing tonight.
So then the fight back, and it was some fight back, wasn't it?
Not half, yeah. I mean, it's a lovely ball in. Alan Main, what are you doing? You forgot to put your cape on. Because he's all over the place, you know. Very unlike Alan Main, he's very consistent normally.
He is too, isn't he?
But you know, I mean, credit to them. I mean, Charlie Muller's got them back in the game.
And his spirit typifies the United will to win there yesterday.
Yeah, and Easton, he's another one who's like that. Young boy who I think managers can manipulate a little bit and say, come on, give me 5% extra. And that turns the thing around from suddenly the level they possibly know, you know, that they have to go and win this game to not rely on next week, not waiting it. And Lily, another good purchase from Alex Smith. Alex Smith has turned this dressing room around. He's made it United, And he's got the spirit there, and that's a wonderful comeback. Look at the happiness and the joy in the dugout. Well done, Alex. He's done ever so well at United.
That is real relief. So United survive. Poor old St Mirren, they win at Love Street against Aberdeen, but they're away.
Yeah, I mean, they've done ever so well lately. I mean, we've seen them coming back against Dundee United. They're doing ever so well. Lovely finish, I believe. Darren Young, as we see, chipping over the goalkeeper. I'm led to believe it hit the back of the net, so, you know, Ava can see it, good angle. Nice left, good finish. Aberdeen, who have been on a good little run themselves.
Yes.
You know, I was expecting that St Mirren could be a little bit, you know, dejected coming here again. I hope Aberdeen and Aberdeen would take advantage, but credit to him, Scott Walker, defender. You know, he's up there, lovely, cool finish. We've seen them, they've battled, they've scrapped in the last few weeks. I've started to maybe just believe that they could upset Dundee United, and the tension would tell. And I have to say that Tom Henry's team have just came a little too late. I mean, they've found it ever so difficult.
But has the experience been good for them, Charlie, in the top?
Yeah, I think overall it has been. There's a lot of kids at St Mirren, we always know that. I mean, he's on loan from Coventry, young McPhee, and it's McGarry, another youngster, you know. There's no doubt that I think McPhee's been impressive. I think he'll get definitely at a club if Coventry don't fancy him. But I think overall, St Mirren have learned. They might have to lose one or two players to go down to the First Division. But I think financially, it's something they can cope with. And I think capable of coming straight back up. But there's no doubt that I think the experience will have done them good. Although it's never pleasant to say that they're going down now after one season. And the red card for Solberg, last-ditch challenge, rather clumsy.
But they've been refreshing, haven't they, in the top flight, St Mirren? Their attitude's been good throughout the whole season.
Well, I think what we've seen is a team who will give everything they have. They're an honest side, their manager's the same. But I think there's a lot of kids in there who will have learned by this. And if they do come back up next season, then the benefit will pay off in long term rather than short term.
And the pictures say it all. Mark Yardley.
Just too late, guys. I mean, a good effort towards the end, but just wasn't enough.
So, the relegation issue is settled. St Mirren will be playing in the First Division next season after Dundee United completed their great escape in Perth. Next Sunday, it's Aberdeen against Dundee United, Dunfermline against St Johnstone, and Motherwell against St Mirren. So, Charlie, finally...
No.
Come on with it. Who's going to get this European spot?
Well, personally, I've said before to you that I would like Kilmarnock to get it. Nothing against Hearts. It's the fact that I think Bobby Williamson does a terrific job at Kilmarnock. I think Hearts have came back in financial problems and Craig Levein is changing the way. And I think it's looking far more promising for Hearts. I have to think that I would slightly favour Kilmarnock getting through, but, you know, I hope me Celtic, which I'm sure is probably the game you're going to have, and Hearts, I hope me Dundee. But Kilmarnock.
You take
probably,
Kilmarnock.
Yeah, well, probably Kilmarnock have to win, and I think with Celtic easing down today, I think Bobby and Kilmarnock will probably just make it.
Don't you go walking down the Gorgie Road in Edinburgh the next few days after that,
I have no plans.
Okay, that's it for tonight. But we're back on Tuesday from 6.30 on Sky Sports 1 with Inside Scottish Football. The next live football on Sky Sports is on Thursday night at 7, when we'll be bringing you one of the Division 1 playoff semi-final second legs. On Friday, you can see the stars of tomorrow when Arsenal take on Blackburn Rovers in the first leg of the FA Youth Cup final. And on Saturday, two live games from the final day of the FA Carling Premiership. It all gets underway from 1 o'clock on Sky Sports 1, where you'll be able to see Charlton against Liverpool. Liverpool, of course, a big week for them. And over on Sky Sports 2 from 3 o'clock, Leeds United against Leicester City. And we're back next Sunday from 2 o'clock on Sky Sports 1 with our final live match from the Bank of Scotland, Scottish Premier League. 0-0 at Easter Road, no goals, but hope you enjoyed it all the same. From Charlie and me, bye-bye.
Bye.